Hi everybody. Welcome to Anatomy with Dr. Rabbit Heart. I'm Teresa Patitucci, a medical educator and anatomist at the Medical College of Wisconsin. The concept in this video was dreamed up by my colleague at MCW, Dr. Beth Krippendorf. In this video, we will teach you how to draw a quick schematic of the brachial plexus. The brachial plexus is a complex network of nerves innervating the shoulder and upper limb, originating from ventral rami of spinal nerves C5 to T1 and giving rise to five levels: roots, trunks, divisions, cords, and branches. Understanding the structure of the brachial plexus along with motor and sensory functions of its branches is important for determining where lesions have occurred in a patient. It can be helpful to be able to draw your own quick diagram of the brachial plexus to help with problem solving. So let's draw together. Grab a piece of paper and a writing utensil, and we will create the schematic shown here. After we're done, you can add additional details to your diagram, like colors and notes, while you continue to study. Begin by drawing the letter Y, I, and another Y. Make the vertical components of these letters fairly long. Next, add a strike and a spare. These are bowling terms, which are indicated by an X and a slash. Now add three arches where the two on the sides meet in the middle. Congratulations! You have completed drawing the basic components of the brachial plexus. Note that we have drawn this structure from the right side of the body. Now let's label our diagram. Draw dotted lines across the diagram and label the five levels: roots, trunks, divisions, cords, and branches. Now let's label the roots, which are composed of ventral rami from spinal nerves C5, C6, C7, C8, and T1. Roots merge to form superior, middle, and inferior trunks. Then each trunk splits, sending some fibers anteriorly and some posteriorly, with all the posterior divisions eventually merging together in the middle. Divisions then become cords, including the lateral, medial, and posterior cords. The posterior cord is formed when all three posterior divisions merge with one another. Cords can be located in lab by using the axillary artery as a landmark, since these cords are named for their relationship to this vessel. Finally, are the five terminal branches of the brachial plexus. Toward the anterior aspect of the body are the musculocutaneous, median, and ulnar nerves, which together make the shape of the letter M. Then the axillary and radial nerves come from the posterior cord and go on to supply the posterior aspect of the upper limb. Now we will add some smaller branches of the brachial plexus. First, draw in the supraclavicular branches, meaning they can be found superior to the clavicle. Add and label the dorsal scapular nerve, coming off of C5, then the subclavian and suprascapular nerves coming off the superior trunk. And then finally, add the long thoracic nerve, which branches from C5, C6, and C7, and extends down the thorax to the serratus anterior muscle. Now add the lateral pectoral nerve off the lateral cord, and the medial pectoral nerve off the medial cord. Also off the medial cord, you can find the medial brachial and antebrachial cutaneous nerves, which travel to the skin of the arm and forearm. Note that all three branches of the medial cord begin with the letter M. Finally, off the posterior cord are the upper subscapular, thoracodorsal, and lower subscapular nerves. Note that along with the radial and axillary nerves, the branches of the posterior cord spell the word ultra. You should now have a fully drawn and labeled brachial plexus diagram to study from. If you want more brachial plexus fun, you can find a labeling activity on Brightspace. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like my artwork, subscribe to my channel or follow me on Twitter or Instagram at @DrRabbitHeart.